I am going to teach you multiplication and division of decimal numbers. All of you look at the board. First question is find the value of. Children, look at A1, 0.0005 into 1000. Children, in multiplication of decimal numbers by 10, 100, 1000, etc., you have to move decimal point to the right side. In multiplier, there are three zeros. Therefore, in multiplicand, decimal point will move to the right side three digits. Decimal point is here. If it moves three digits, it will come before 5. So, answer will be 0.5. Answer will 0.5. Look at B. It is 1005.3 into 1000. Multiplier is 1000 and it has 30. Therefore, decimal point has to move 3 digits to the right side. But as you notice here, there is only 1 digit after decimal point. It should be equal to 3 digits because in multiplier there are 3 zeros. So we will put 2 zero here. 1 0, 2 0, and now decimal point will move 3 digits to the right side. Hence, the decimal point will go out of the number. So answer will be 1005300. This is the answer. Children, look at C1. 16.32 you have to multiply by 8. Children, ignore this decimal point in right. 1632, multiply it by 8. This is multiplication of whole numbers. 8 2s are 16, 1 carried. 8 3s are 24 plus 1, 25, 2 carried. 8 6s are 48 plus 2, 50, 5 carried. 1 8s are 8 plus 5, 13. Now, in the multiplicand, decimal point is here. Decimal point is here. And after decimal point, as you can see, there are two digits. Therefore, in the product, 13,056, from left, from right to left, we will count two digits and place the decimal point. So, one digit, two digit, decimal point will be placed here, before 5. So, answer is 130.56. Look at this. D1, 3.481 into 1.6. Again, ignore decimal point and write as whole number 3481, and here it is 16. Multiply them. 1 6 is 6, 8 6 is 48, 4, 6 4 is 24, plus 4, 28, 2, 6 3 is 18, plus 2, 20. Now multiply by 1, 1 into 1, 1, 8 into 1, 8, 4 into 1, 4, and 3 into 1, 3. Add them. 6, 9, 16, 5, and 5. Now, decimal point is before 4 in the multiplicand. Here, in the multiplier, it is before 6. Children, count number of digits after decimal point in multiplicand. It is 3, and in multiplier, after decimal point, there is 1 digit. So, if we add 3 and 1, we are getting 4. That means, in the product, from right to left, you will count 4 digits and place the decimal point. So, let us place decimal point. 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit. So, it will come before 5 here. So, the answer is 5.5696. This is the answer. Now, see division. I will have to rub this. Look here, children. We have to divide 16.48 by 10. Division is opposite of multiplication. In division, decimal point moves to the right side. Therefore, in division, decimal point will move to the left side, equal to the number of zero in divisor. In divisor, here we have 1 0. So decimal point will move to the left side 1 digit. So it will come before 6. So answer will be 1.648. Look at the second example. 48.7 divided by 1000. So in 1000 there are 3 zeros. Therefore, in dividend, decimal point should move 3 digits to the left side. But as you notice, there are only 2 digits, 4 and 8. We need 3 digits. How can we have 3 digits here? We will put 1 0. And now decimal point will come before 0. So answer will be 0.0487. I think you have understood multiplication and division of decimal numbers. So I stop here, children. Thank you.